ahead, you can see the hill of the Acropolis. In a minute you'll be able to see Parthenon on top.
Greece, on the Mediterranean, is located between Albania and Turkey, bordering the Aegean Sea to the east and the Ionian Sea to the west. The country is slightly smaller than the state of Alabama in the United States and has a coastline of about 8,500 miles, although some sources state that the coastline is about 9,400 miles. Athens is a sprawling metropolis surrounded by mountains. Ancient Athens reached its peak in the 5th century BC, and today the Parthenon on top of the Acropolis is one of the world's most famous buildings. The Parthenon is a Doric temple to Athena, the patron goddess of the city. A few of the original sculptures can still be admired on the east pediment. From the Acropolis, you have a view of the Theater of Dionysus and the Temple of Olympian Zeus, with two Corinthian columns behind Hadrian's Arch. At the foot of the Acropolis is the Athenian Agora, which was the political and religious heart of ancient Athens. The rebuilt Stoa contains a museum exhibiting artifacts found in the Agora. The Plaka area is the historic heart of Athens. Few buildings date further back than the Ottoman era in the 1400s. However, it remains the oldest continuously inhabited area of the city. Tourists and Athenians alike enjoy the many old-fashioned tavernas and outdoor restaurants, along with the antique, icon, and souvenir shops. Many streets are for pedestrians only. The area retains the atmosphere of a traditional neighborhood. Coming up, you will see the changing of the guard at the Parliament. This Olympic Stadium hosted the first Olympic Games in 1896. It is constructed of white marble. Athens has many museums. The Acropolis Museum, after a decade of planning, is a must. Also, the Pinaki Museum is one you should not miss. This museum has something of interest for everyone, dating from the 11th century BC.
Talking, they were moving the head, the little stalks, the flowers were moved. This was a hair piece. Sometimes people believe that was a breast piece, that was a hair piece, to have all the filigree technique. As you remember, I told you that there were golden mines in ancient Greece, but they were poor and they were soon exhausted. But that's why they developed so early, all the goldsmiths developed all the techniques of the filigree, which is at this side, the big one. Of a woman right here, that it seems that they got the idea of making this portrait from the Fayum portrait, right here, that mosaic that you will see, the ones that they're going to Istanbul, when you go to St. Sophia, that is the replica of the mosaic decoration that you see right there. It's a nice mosaic, but it's not a good replica of the magnificent mosaics that you see when you go to St. Sophia Church. So, Anna and Mother in Greek, Mitir, Theou, M-R, Mitir, Mother of God, was always what was above the head of each man. They used to make a special curtain just to let them be for a while at Rhodes. Now this comes from Rhodes, from the island of Rhodes. This is Arabic, this is Asian, but it's not Western Europe. So this is a little chest where with the ivory, with inlaid in ivory, mother of pearl, like the other one.
Night falls on Athens. Next up is a visit to Delphi, northwest of Athens, situated above the Gulf of Corinth, east of the Ionian Sea. Delphi was the seat of the oldest and most sacred sanctuary of the famous Oracle of Apollo in ancient Greece. At this shrine, inquiries were made to the ancient gods and priestesses. The site was regarded as the center of the earth. This sanctuary reached the peak of its political influence in the 5th and 4th centuries BC. Excavations were begun by the French in 1892. The site includes the Sacred Way, a road once lined with treasuries and statues, the Temple of Apollo, and an amphitheater still in use today. The museum has preserved many of these ancient artifacts. Delphi's modern philosophy was well summarized by one of the inscriptions on the wall of the Temple of Apollo, "Know thyself."